Glory be to the one triune Lord. Amen. When Jesus came to be baptized, John tried to prevent him by saying, I was supposed to be baptized by you, but now you are coming to me. But Jesus said to him, Permit it to be so, as it fulfills all the righteousness, and then he allowed him. St. Matthew chapter 3, verse 14 and 15. The meaning of the word Deneha, which is Syrian, is sunrise and dawn, which makes the faithful understand the significance of the feast. It is also called Epiphany and Theophany in Latin. It can also be stated that Jesus is the real sun that dawned in the world through incarnation. During the hidden life of Jesus in Nazareth, the public did not understand that he is the real sun who illuminates the world through his light of humanity. He was manifested to public by God the Father through baptism, as we have seen above. John the Baptist bore witness to divine commission of Jesus to baptize with the Holy Spirit, as he saw the Spirit descending upon Jesus in the form of dove. Being the purest of the pure, Jesus accepted baptism, and this shows the impact and significance of baptism in Christianity. Also, we see the Sunday after Deneha has a greater significance, as Jesus calls his first two disciples, that is none other than Simon and Peter. The Gospel is read from St. Matthew chapter 4, verse 12 to 22. In this Gospel, we see that Jesus called these first disciples not to a very comfortable life, but he called them to a life full of danger and risk. Each one would die for the sake to follow this man, and also they agreed to this. He called them to a life in which they would do something for themselves by giving their whole life to him. This shows their courage to follow Christ by doing anything, and this is something you and me should surely possess. At last, I hope these words enlightened you to know the deeper meaning and significance of Deneha, and gives you courage to follow Christ when he calls each one of us. Until then, let the Lord bless each one of us. Amen.